give myself away. I give myself away so you can use me. I give myself away. I give myself away so you can. Come on, let him know. I give myself away. I give myself away so you can use me. I give myself away. What would happen if a generation embraced this? Come on, tell them, here I am,
here I am.
Yeah.
read from the start. Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord. Who has given themselves away this morning to the Lord? We just thank God on this day, and we welcome you, welcome you, welcome you to the Martha McCauley Area Recommit, Reconnect, our virtual worship service. So we just thank you all for being here this morning on an early, guess kind of chilly Saturday morning. We just thank God that all you lovely people are here today. Giving honor to God to our Bishop James Levert, our presiding prelate of the Second Episcopal District, Mother Irelis Beavers Davis, our Episcopal supervisor, Ms. D. Faye Conley, our Episcopal District WMS president, Ms. Annette Dockery, our Episcopal YPD director, Mr. Richard Jackson, our Episcopal YPD president, Mrs. Nikki Walker Lyons, our Western North Carolina WMS president, Mrs. Alice Hillman, our Western North Carolina Conference YPD director, Mr. Abdu Knox, our Western North Carolina Conference YPD president, to the Reverend Robert L. Hodges, our senior pastor, Mrs. Faye Hooker, the Addie G. Stroud WMS local president, Mrs. Lola Hager, Addie G. Stroud WMS YPD director, Ms. Jayla Adams, our WMS YPD president on the local level. Of course, our beautiful Mrs. Diane Tawab, our Martha McCauley area WMS chairperson, Mrs. Myris Thompson, our Martha McCauley area YPD director, and Ms. Natea Lee Jones, our Martha McCauley area YPD president. Greetings to you all on this day. Again, we are so happy that you're joining the Martha McCauley area third, can you believe it, third annual Recommit, Reconnect virtual worship service. How many of y'all just raise your hand if you thank God that we still connect virtually and can continue on one accord to give God the praise? Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So at this time, we will have our call to worship. And we're hoping that you can unmute for this so that we can all respond together. Listen up, my brothers and sisters. It is a joy to be worshiping the Lord together. Let us shout joyfully to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving.
Let us worship. Let us sing. Hallelujah to the King. Let us raise our voices high and pray in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen, amen, amen. How many of you all come to worship and praise our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ on today? Let's give the Lord a great big hand clap.
Amen.
We just thank God that we can again do it from the comfort of our own homes, be safe in this time of pandemic, which seems that he doesn't want to let us go. But that's all right. God's got a backup plan as always. And the backup plan is the forefront plan for this past year. So we just thank God that we're still able to see one another. So now we will have our invocation by Sister Lee Badger, our worship leader for the Martha McCauley Area WMS. She's the local president of the Lee B. Nipper WMS at Living Waters here in Raleigh. Amen, Sister Linda.
Father God, we give you praise this morning. Our Father and our God, we gather together today in this virtual worship service to honor you first and to recommit our lives to you for the work of missions of the Martha McCauley area. Bless, Lord God, all of our leaders of this great area. Forgive us of every sin, every transgression, every iniquity. Clean our hearts, God, and put your Holy Spirit gifts of grace, peace, mercy, and favor. Help us to understand your word in Jesus' name. Now, therefore, our God, we thank you and praise your glorious, magnificent, marvelous, and wonderful, pure, righteous, and holy name. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Thank you so much, Sister Badger. Now we will have our scripture by Sister Ida McGill, the president of the Davis McLean WMS at Joseph Temple in Laurinburg. She will do the Old and New Testament. Oh, did we lose this? Oh, there she is. Sister McGill, unmute. Unmute yourself. Okay.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I will be reading from the King James Version of the Bible. And I will read the Old Testament, Judges 7, chapter 17 through 21. And he said unto them, look on men and do likewise. And behold, when I come to the outside of the camp, it shall be that as I do, so shall ye do. When I blow with a trumpet, I and all that are with me, then blow ye the trumpet also on every side of all the camp, and say, the sword of the Lord and of Gilead. So Gilead and the 100 men that were with him came unto the outside of the camp in the beginning of the middle watch. And they had but newly set the watch, and they blew the trumpet and brake the pitchers that were in their hands. And the three companies blew the trumpet and brake the pitcher and held the lamps in their left hands and the trumpets in their right hands to blow with. And they cried, the sword of the Lord and of Gilead. And they stood every man in his place round about the camp. And all the host ran and cried and fled. The New Testament reading will come from 2 Timothy 1 through 7. Thou therefore, my son, be strong in the grace that is in Christ Jesus. And the things that thou hast heard of me among many witnesses, the same commit thou to faithful men who shall be able to teach others also. Then therefore, endure hardness as a good soldier of Jesus Christ. No man that warreth entangle himself with the affairs of this life, that he may please him who has chosen him to be a soldier. And if a man also strive for masteries, yet is he not crowned, except he strive lawfully. The husbandman that labor must be first partaker of the fruits. Consider what I say, and the Lord give the understanding in all things. God bless the reading of his read word.
Amen, amen, amen. Thank you, Sister McGill. Now we will be favored by a musical selection.
People go.
People go.
Your life has been out of control.
Out of control.
You're confused.
But
don't worry.
Don't worry.
Your heart.
It's in your heart.
Amen, amen. How many know that it will and it already has gotten better? Just as mere fact, we have new administration in the White House. It's already better in 2021. So we thank God for that. I had to mute myself because I know y'all didn't want to hear my version of it will get better. So now we will have our welcome and greetings by Sister Faye Hooker, the local president of Addie G. Stroud WMS, our host society this morning here at St. Paul Amy Church in Raleigh, our host church, followed by the solo by Brother Morris Sterling, also St. Paul Amy Raleigh.
Good morning. Greetings to everyone. It is an honor for the Addie G. Stroud Women's Missionary Society to have this opportunity to host the 2021 Reconnect, Recommit Worship Service. The members of the Addie G. Stroud Women's Missionary Society, located at 402 West Edenton Street, Raleigh, North Carolina, where our pastor is none other than Reverend Robert L. Hodges, Sr., welcome you to this virtual experience. We trust that you joined us this morning with great expectations and an open heart to hear a song of encouragement, a scripture verse that confirms God's presence, and a message that will reignite us to continue the work of missions. A special welcome to Sister Sylvia Blake, our connectional member at large. We are excited that your busy schedule would allow you to join us today. As always, we are happy to have the presence of Supervisor Yvonne Henning Parks. A special welcome and greeting also to our life members. One, if you are visiting from one of our sister areas, we welcome you with open arms. If you are a visitor because you were invited by another missionary, we extend a heartfelt welcome to you. And many, many thanks for all who are here today. Now that you have been officially greeted and welcome, let us take full advantage of this opportunity to reconnect and recommit ourselves to so that we will be well equipped for the work of missions. Welcome.
Trouble don't last always. Said I'm so glad, yes I'm so glad. Trouble don't last always. I'm so glad, yes I'm so glad. Trouble don't last always. Said I'm so glad. Trouble don't last always. Listen. It may not come when you want it, but he's on time. In times of trouble, I found him to be a friend of mine. Rise, he'll be there. All your burdens, I know the Lord will help you to bear. Hey. And I'm so glad. Trouble don't last always. Said I'm so glad, yes I'm so glad. Trouble don't last always. Listen. It may not come when you want him, but he's on time. In times of trouble, I find him to be a friend of mine. When storm clouds rise in your life, he will be there. Every one of your burdens, I know the Lord will help you to bear. And I'm so glad trouble don't last always. Said I'm so glad, yes I'm so glad trouble don't last always. Yeah, yeah. Lay into the light, keep the faith, it will be alright. We've been led into the light, keep the faith, it will be alright. Woo! Praise break, y'all. Come on, put your hands together. Trouble don't last always. No, 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 no. Trouble don't last always. Hey. Trouble don't last always. No, 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 no. Trouble don't last always. Hey, yeah, trouble. It don't last always. Trouble. It don't last always. Trouble don't last always. No, 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 no. Trouble don't last always. Hey, say trouble don't last always. No, 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 no. Trouble don't last always. Hey, trouble don't last always. It has to go away. Trouble don't last always. Hey, come on. Let's break it down one time. Y'all ready? Hey. Trouble don't last always, always. And trouble don't last always. All you gotta do is keep the faith and believe and fall on your knees and pray. Say trouble don't last always, always. And trouble don't last always. All you gotta do is keep the faith and believe and fall on your knees and pray. Hey, trouble, it don't last always, yeah. I say trouble, it has to go away, yeah, yeah, yeah. Trouble, you just gotta keep the faith, yeah. Because we've been led into the light. Keep the faith, it will be alright. We've been led into the light. Keep the faith, it will be alright.
Amen, amen. Let's give Brother Sterling a round of applause. Praise the Lord. I'm telling you, now that should have got you going this morning. So we thank Sister Faye Hooker for that beautiful welcome. And I love our sisterhood here at Martha McCauley because she catch what I miss. So praise the Lord for Sister Hooker and for Brother Sterling's awesome, awesome rendition of Trouble Don't Last Always. I hope y'all picking up a theme that we got going here at Martha McCauley. It will get better. And now trouble don't last always. Trouble don't last always. So praise the Lord. We're looking for bigger and better things as God allows in 2021. So now, Sister Winifred, she said, you're going to bring me in? I'm bringing in, Sister Winifred. So now we will have Sister Winifred Hinton, our Martha McCauley area WMS treasurer, followed by another musical selection. Amen.
Good morning, everyone. To God be the glory for all he has done for us. And trouble don't last always. At this time, we all can participate in the service with an offering. It has been requested that each of us will participate with a giving of $10. And please make your checks payable to the Martha McCauley area. And on the memo line, indicate your church name. Your donation will be acknowledged. Thank you for your giving. Be blessed and be safe.
Amen, amen. Nobody greater. If you think you know somebody greater than God, don't tell me. I don't want to know, because I know he's the greatest thing going. So we just thank God for that. Now, On Mission will be presented by our own Sister Molly Williams, our young adult missionary, who's our third vice president for the Martha McCauley area, followed by the presentation of our preacher for the hour. And that will be led by Sister Ida Pope, the local president of May Hobson WMS and Union Bethel AME Church here in Cary.
Good morning, my sisters in Christ and our visitors. I will be presenting a poem by Amina Brown, and it's called On Mission. We find ourselves before the one true God, hands open, heart laid, and broken. We want to serve him. We want his name to be the very foundation upon which we build our lives, to be eyes through which we see the world, our community, ourselves. We want to walk the roads of Jesus with the name dust on our feet. We want to build bridges instead of burn them. We want to love with the kind of love that flops over tables in temples and dare the religions to cast stones and judgments. And is willing to share a table with sinners and betrayers. This calling is bigger than a career. Extends beyond a job or a formal position. This mission is eternal, bigger than anything we could have come up with ourselves. We are picking up that mission Jesus left for us. We are doing what he told us. Love God, love our neighbor, love yourself, and take your cross. Deny yourself, follow me, make disciples, teach them the way, walk in the Spirit. Speak the truth, but make sure you live it too. Jesus is calling his disciples to put down our nets, to serve and love our neighbors, next door and across the world. Jesus is calling all of us, whether we need to walk across the street, reach across the table, move across the country, make our home across the world, live in community, learn a new language, practice talking less and listening more, pray and discern what God has in store. This plow we put our hands to, this work we commit our lives to, is just not easy. There is plenty of harvest, but very few hands. But we will not grow weary in well-doing. We ask God, who plans and waters and harvests and reaps, to send the brave and the wise, to send the women and the men and the children, to send the leaders and the influencers, to send the elders and the young, to send artists, engineers, teachers, farmers, preachers, mechanics, musicians, athletes, architects, to send those who will befriend and walk alongside, to send those who will again and again offer their lives. We will not be a generation who is lulled to sleep by empathy, by selfishness, and by capacity. We are the people who will be moved to action, to walk humbly, to love mercy, and to do just. We want God to send us to Seattle coffee shops and Shanghai startups, London streets and St. Louis neighborhoods, to skyscrapers, to street corners, in Detroit and in Dubai. No matter where we go, when God sends us on a mission, we will answer with our whole lives. Thank you. And that was a poem that was written by Amina Brown, who is a spoken word artist, and she is from Atlanta, Georgia.
Good morning. It is my pleasure to introduce the preacher of the hour, Reverend Gwendolyn Marie Wise Blackman. Reverend Wise Blackman was ordained in the African Methodist Episcopal Church as an itinerant elder in May 2016. Prior to moving with her family to Cary, North Carolina, and accepting her call to the ministry, she served in various lay functions at Bethel Amy Church in Wilmington, Delaware, under the guidance of the pastor, Reverend Dr. Sylvester S. Beeman. As a former member of the ministerial staff at Lincolnville AME Church, Raleigh, North Carolina, Reverend Wise Blackman served in several capacities, including the grief ministry, Christian education, and health and wellness. Currently, she is the pastor of Union Bethel AME Church in Cary, North Carolina, where practicing God's love is exceptional. Reverend Wise Blackman holds a Bachelor of Science in Biology from the Massachusetts Institute of Technology, a Doctorate of Philosophy in Pharmacology from the University of Virginia, and a Master of Divinity from Shaw University Divinity School. She has held numerous positions in the pharmaceutical industry, receiving awards for her dedication and customer focus. Currently, Dr. Wise Blackman is owner and principal consulting of a biopharmaceutical firm, Gwen Wise Blackman Consult, and also serves as state lead for Mayan Women Mentors, North Carolina, an advisory council that advises the Justice Warren Task Force. Reverend Wise Blackman is a member of the Sisters Network Triangle, a breast cancer survivor network focused on raising awareness in the African American community. She is the coordinator of the Western North Carolina Conference Women in Ministry and co-chair of the Wake County AME Church Cluster. Reverend Wise Blackman and her husband, Reginald Blackman, celebrated 29 years of marriage in August 2020. They have one son, Justin Blackman, a graduate student at North Carolina A&T University. Reverend Wise Blackman enjoys combining her love of God and God's people with her love of science. She sees scientific discovery fitting in God's plan for humanity. As we perform the process of peeling away the layers of creation, we will find God in all things. Throughout her life, she relied on Philippians 4:13. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me to be her guide in difficult situations. I present to some and introduce to others the Reverend Gwendolyn Wise Blackman. Thank you.
Amen, amen. We will have our solo by Sister Deborah Wilkins of St. Paul, followed by the message. God bless.
How can I say thanks for all the things you've done for me? Things so undeserved, yet you gave to prove your love for me. The voice that
Amen and amen. And thank you. To God be the glory. I know protocol has already been established, but I still want to bring greetings and recognize our bishop, the Right Reverend James Levert Davis, and his wonderful wife, our supervisor, Aurelis Beavis Davis. I want to recognize the North Carolina component of the Western North Carolina component of the Women's Missionary Society, Sister Nikki Walker Lyons, and thank you, Sister Diane Tawab, area chairperson for Martha McCauley area, for inviting me to bring the message this morning. And Sister Pope, when you asked me for my biography, I didn't know you were going to read it in its entirety, or I would have made it shorter for you. But thank you for that introduction. Good morning. Today is a recommit and reconnect service. So let us look at Exodus 19, verses 16 to 19. The New Revised Standard Version. On the morning of the third day, there was thunder and lightning, as well as a thick cloud on the mountain, and a blast of a trumpet so loud that all the people who were in the camp trembled. Moses brought the people out of the camp to meet God. They took their stand at the foot of the mountain. Now Mount Sinai was wrapped in smoke because the Lord had descended upon it in fire. The smoke went up like the smoke of a kiln, while the whole mountain shook violently. As the blast of the trumpet grew louder and louder, Moses would speak and God would answer him in thunder. This morning, Martha McCauley area, we bring the thunder. Let us pray. God, we thank you for this preaching moment. We thank you for this opportunity at the beginning of 2021 to reconnect to you and recommit our lives to service in your kingdom, God. God, we thank you for everyone on this Zoom meeting and even those who wanted to be here but could not. Now, God, we need a word from heaven. Doesn't matter what sermon I prepared, God, we need to hear from heaven. So move anything out of the way that would try to prevent us from hearing from you this morning, God. Allow me to bring this message in the way you want it to be brought. Oh God, help me to preach this morning. In the name of Christ Jesus, I pray. Amen. We bring the thunder. God was ready to take the Hebrew people to a new level. They were already out of Egypt and they were already in the desert. And they were already trying to get to the promised land. On the one hand, they were free of their captivity. But on the other, they needed guidance from God to know how to be the people God was calling them to be. God was calling them to reconnect and recommit to be God's people, to be set aside for God's purpose. To do this, they had to be priestly and they had to be holy. Not just the priests had to be priestly, but the people had to be priestly and holy. And God would reveal the message that he had for the people through Moses. But before God could do that, Moses had to get their people ready. They had to consecrate themselves and then draw near when they heard the trumpet to the foot of Mount Sinai, where they would hear God speak. So on the morning of that third day, God spoke to the people as they were gathered around the foot of the mountain. And what the people heard was thunder. When God speaks in thunder, God does it to get our attention. When God speaks in thunder, false prophets will fall. When God speaks in thunder, unjust systems will fail. When God speaks in thunder, wickedness in high places is exposed. When God speaks in thunder, God uses God's emissaries to bring the thunder. When God speaks to the world through missionaries, God speaks
in the thunder. So my question today for this recommit and reconnect service is, do you just hear the thunder? Or are you part of bringing the thunder? When we hear thunder, something perks up in us. Typically, thunder serves as a warning for us that something is getting ready to happen. If I can get technical for just a little moment, because Sister Pope told you about my science background, so I find God in everything in this world. When God created lightning, God designed a stream of electrons to move between the earth and the clouds, or clouds and the earth, or between two clouds in the sky. That movement heats up the surrounding air. As the air cools, it begins to resonate, to move in a pattern within a vacuum. The pattern rapidly expands and contracts and forms a vibration. We hear that vibration as thunder. God created thunder to form in response to high heat and rapid movement. So the first thing that God is saying to us today is missionaries recommitted to an all-knowing God and reconnecting to an all-powerful God will go places where there is a vacuum that needs heat and action. In these vacuums, there's an absence of love. There's an absence of compassion. There's an absence of sharing. There's a lack of respect for personhood. When missionaries enter the vacuum, the atmosphere gets heated up and things start to move and change quickly. Recommitted and reconnected missionaries are changing the atmosphere everywhere they go, and people hear the thunder. So it was with Moses and the Hebrew people at the bottom of the mountain on that third day. There was thunder and lightning on Mount Sinai on that morning. When Moses spoke and God answered, the people heard thunder. When missionaries speak in one voice with determination and a singular focus on a goal, people hear thunder. Do you hear it? Do you hear the thunder all around you every time you move? Because you're not moving alone. You're moving with the Most High God. God is ordering your steps and directing your steps, and God is speaking with you and for you, and there's thunder in the atmosphere. God brought the Hebrew people from desolation, desperation, and despair in Egypt to the cusp of life and freedom in their own land. Does that sound like the last 4 years to you, that we were in desolation, desperation, and some in despair? Yet we prayed that God would speak in the thunder, and God spoke in the thunder of footsteps that made a change. There are people living on the edges of this world that need the same hope that the Hebrew people had as they gathered at the foot of the mountain. God still needs people who will recommit and reconnect and be willing to bring God's voice to places that other people don't want God to speak, willing to bring the thunder with them. Today, we don't just reconnect and recommit, we bring thunder because God speaks through us. Don't you hear it? There's a rumbling in the land. Don't you hear it? Do you not sense that the atmosphere is getting hot with the movement of missionaries who are fighting for and speaking for those people who have been kicked aside and deemed unimportant and irrelevant? It's heating up. Secondly, we hear thunder in the thousands of missionaries marching together to bring a change to evil policies. There's some evil in this world. We hear thunder in the thousands of footsteps of those walking with a steadier gait because a missionary served them a meal. A missionary gave them a coat. A missionary offered them a blanket. A missionary presented them with a purse that was filled with just a few of life's necessity. And a missionary showed them some love. And a missionary said,
Do you want to know about the Jesus that I know, the Jesus that I love, the Jesus that saved my soul? A missionary offered them salvation through Christ Jesus, priestly and holy. The thunder is not just in the words that God speaks. The thunder is in the change that is made. This holy appointment that was between God and Moses and the Hebrew people was a preamble to God giving Moses a significant policy change, the Ten Commandments. Read about it. Go back and read about it in Exodus 20. Exodus 19 was just getting them ready to receive what was coming in Exodus 20. God spoke in the thunder, and there was policy change. The change was in how people would not only relate to God, but how they would relate to each other. The things that God wanted God's people to do, to worship God, and then to be in relationship with each other. When there's thunder, get ready for a change. When there's thunder, something is happening. There's going to be a difference soon. We cannot bring the thunder of God's voice with us and not expect that there will be a policy change. The change starts in us. And then we go to the dry and desolate places with pronouncements that God has said something is about to be different. We connect with God in our mountaintop experiences to understand the depth and the breadth of our power and authority. But then we go to the foot of the mountain. We go to the places where people are lost. We go to places where people are hiding from other folk. We go to places where people have fallen in a ditch. We go to places where people are in their valley experience after we've come off of our mountaintop experience, and we say, here is the thunder, because God is with me as I speak. We can recommit to making changes, not just in us, but in how the world sees people that the world doesn't want to see, that the world wants to forget exists, that the world wants to act like they don't need anything or shouldn't get anything because someone doesn't like who they are. None of us, not one of us, is really free if there's anyone suffering under policies that are designed to steal, kill, or maim. There must be policy change. But change is not easy, and change requires force. So thirdly, missionaries working with power and authority move in unison, and their footsteps sound like thunder, bringing a forceful change. Thunder gets our attention. We can be inside and we hear thunder and we know the weather is about to change. Something's happening in the atmosphere because we can hear thunder. When missionaries reconnect and recommit, thunder ought to be rolling in the distance because the atmosphere is heating up and it's about to change. Reconnected and recommitted missionaries are forced to be reckoned with because the thunderous voice of God affirms that the missionaries are bringing the reckoning. A reckoning is coming and a choice has to be made. You're either with God or you're refusing to hear God and you're running from the thunder. There's power in the thunder. Missionaries, we bring thunder in our voices that rise up to speak against racism, sexism, ageism, classism, any other kind of ism that's out there. All of these artificial barriers created to separate people from each other. And in some instances, created to separate people from God and God's love. Missionaries walk in the power of the thunder that's in your footsteps. Hear it every time you move. If you don't hear it, somebody else is. Let the thunder that you bring be a warning to everybody who would oppose the assignment that God has for you, that nothing will get in your way. Let the thunder be an announcement for all who are waiting that change is coming in your footsteps. Let the thunder be a moment of awakening for all who have fallen asleep in complacency, that it's time to get moving. The Martha McCauley Area Women's Missionary Society, you bring the thunder. Reconnect, recommit. Nothing and no one will get in your way because you bring the thunder. Amen and amen. If there's anyone in the call today that doesn't know who Jesus is, the Jesus that we serve, the Jesus that we love, that loves us, the Son of the Most High God, who died for us and then rose again on the third day with all power in his hand. If you don't know who that Jesus is, I give you Jesus today. I invite you to connect and recommit. If you committed a while ago, recommit to that Jesus today. This is an invitation to Christian discipleship. So I first have to frame it as if you don't really know who Jesus is, I need you to know who Jesus is. But if you know who Jesus is and you really haven't been walking as a disciple, you haven't been walking in the way you know God wants you to walk. You've done some things, or as we used to call it, no, back in the day, backslid, or and you need to be in the presence of the Lord, reconnect and recommit today. Jesus has never said that you fall and then we won't help you get back up. People ask Jesus, well, how many times should we forgive? And Jesus said, just forgive. He gave a number, but what Jesus meant is just forgive. Forgive yourself. Ask God to forgive you and reconnect and recommit today. Reach out to one of your missionary sisters. They will connect you to the pastor, and the pastor will help you in the recommitting and reconnecting that you need to do. We all must be disciples of the Most High God. Let us pray. God, we thank you. We thank you, God, just because you're you. We thank you, God, for this glorious morning. We thank you, God, for the sun that is shining outside. And God, if there's some place across this world where someone is watching on this Zoom call and they're not in the sun, we still thank you for the clouds or for the rain or for the snow or for the blizzards and the storms, God. We still thank you for those, God. We thank you for the changing in the atmosphere. It not just in this country, but across the world, God. God, we ask, God, that these missionaries gather together that want to reconnect to you and recommit to you, God, that you receive their hearts with open hands, that you help them, God, understand what it means to walk for you, God, and to speak for you, God, and to go places where there is a need, God, for those who are suffering and those who don't feel in their soul the love that you have for them, God. We ask, God, that you take us and wash us, God, and remove anything that is hindering us from being true disciples, God, as we reconnect and recommit. God, we ask you to show us through your Holy Spirit those things that are not good for us, that we need to just kick the and walk away from and kick the dirt off of our feet and just keep walking away from it, God, because it's keeping us from what you've called us to do. Oh, God, wash us again. Renew our minds, God. Help us to connect to you, reconnect, and recommit our lives for service to you. In the name of Christ Jesus, we pray. Amen and amen. Thank you.
Amen. Let's give Reverend Rye Blackman a round of applause. Amen. Amen. Didn't you feel that in your spirit? I'm telling you, Reverend Blackman, I'm ready to run on a little while longer. I tell you, thank you, God, for that word, bring the thunder. Do you just hear the thunder, or are you part of bringing the thunder? So we want to be part of bringing the thunder here in Martha McCauley area in the Western North Carolina Conference. Praise God, praise God. I'm fired up now, that Reverend Blackman. I really am. I tell you, I'm ready to run on. I tell you, thank you, God. So we just thank you for that word that you brought on this morning. It recharged us and recommitted us. Thank you so much. Now we will have the charge to missions ministry by our own Sister Sylvia Blake, the Connectional Member at Large of the Women's Missionary Society. followed by remarks by our sister Nikki Walker Lyons, our Commerce Branch President of the Western North Carolina Conference WMS, Sister Diane Tawab, our area chair of the Martha McCauley area WMS, and then our host pastor, Reverend Robert L. Hodges, senior pastor at St. Paul AME Church here in Raleigh. Amen. Sister Blake.
My dear brothers and sisters in missions ministry, today you have recommitted and reconnected your service to the Almighty God. Missions ministry is a blessing and serious responsibility. It recognizes your special gifts and calls you to work among those that are often looked down upon, overlooked, neglected, rejected, abandoned, hated, abused, and mistreated. I thank you for your willingness to serve and challenge you on this day to offer your best to the Lord, to the people in your various communities, and to our ministry throughout the world. Today, summon the courage to follow God, even if the path seems difficult, even if your heart is fearful and frightened. Trust our Heavenly Father and follow Him. Beloved, trust Him with your day and your life. Do His work, care for His children, and share His good news to all. Let the Lord guide your steps daily. I promise you, if you trust Him, He will not ever lead you astray. My brothers and sisters in missions ministry, work together as one unified body in missions to make sure that His will is completed to fulfill God's commission, our mission, our calling. So today, go forth and let His light shine.
Amen. Amen. To God be the glory for this beautiful service today. Just to God be the glory, period. This has been a beautiful service. And I just thank God for the opportunity for us to be here today. We're not just recommitting and reconnecting ourselves to the work of missions, but to God and quite frankly, to each other, because we need each other to bring that thunder. And Dr. Gwendolyn Wise Blackman, I was just sitting here thinking about, we're just bringing this thunder. So you got, I'm telling you, that was wonderful. Thank you, Lord Jesus, because when we as missionaries move, mighty things happen. The world hears us. They know we're on the way. And so I just thank God for this. So just to get a little bit of protocol, I'm so excited. I didn't even get my protocol in, but we are just so thankful to the Lord. We do honor our bishop and Mother Davis and to our Episcopal president who I spoke with the other day to let her know about this service. And we thank God for our district leadership. And to Sister Sylvia Blake, you know, Sister Sylvia, we you're home, you know, your sister is in our conference. So this is just another home, but we send our love and greetings to your district. We honor you for the work that you do in missions and the wonderful way you as a young woman represent missions. We are proud to know you. Welcome to our conference. We love you. And I just thank you for being here. We recognize, and y'all, I got notes, but I'm just kind of going all over right now. Of course, we recognize our supervisor, Yvonne Henning Parks, whom we love and adore and appreciate her for all that she does. To this awesome preacher, Reverend Gwendolyn Wise Blackman, we just thank you. You blessed us, I think, 2 years ago at our annual day, and you always have a mighty word. We honor God for the healing that He has done in your life. And that we thank God that you bless us in such a wonderful way. And I saw all of us, we're sitting here writing notes. So we have a mighty, mighty word to take us into everything that God has for us. Also, I do want to, of course, acknowledge, want to thank our presider today. Now, Sister Charlene, I don't know if anybody else has said this to you, and I don't know if anybody else has caught it. They probably did. but you represent your mother very well in that hat today, my darling. So we honor the life, the legacy of your mom, Sister Delarice Copeland Walker. Thank you for wearing her hat today. You are wearing it well, my sister. To this awesome area chairperson, a friend and sister beloved, Sister Diane Tawa, we just recognize you, Sister Diane. This was your vision for the area, and it has grown, and what it has done for your area has been amazing. So we just thank God for the visionary that you are, for your love for the work of missions, your commitment to it, and we just honor you for being who you are to each and every one of us, and we thank God for you to the host church, St. Paul, Pastor Hodges, First Lady Hodges, thank you for being our host, our awesome host today, and all of the technical staff and all the singers and everything that St. Paul has done to host this commitment, recommit and reconnect service today. I think those are my last words. I do want to also recognize Sister Alice couldn't be on, but we do recognize Sister Thompson, Sister Marius, for your work with our young people, our YPDers. We recognize you. You don't have an easy job, and so we just want to make sure we shout you out because you do an awesome job. Thank you, one and all of those who are visiting from other areas. Thank you for the support that you've given to Sister Diane, to Sister Marius, and to the Martha McCauley area. I love you all. Let us just continue the work and the service that God has certainly called us to. It is not easy, and these are not easy times. But one thing we have witnessed this week, it does not matter. We know the scripture and we know the word that those that come against us will never prevail. It won't happen. We watched people attacking our nation's capital. And a week or 2 weeks later, when we had the inauguration this week, we're back on the Capitol. And it just lets us know that no weapon formed against us shall prosper. It may form, it might bite, it might sting, but at the end of the day, it won't prosper. So to God be the glory. Thank you, Sister Diane, for leading us in such a wonderful way. God bless you all.
Sister Diane, I'm mute.
And I'm talking to myself. So I heard myself very clearly. Good morning to everyone. Thank you, Madam President, for your wisdom, for your leadership, for the way that you have conducted yourself, an example for us to lead. Thank you, everyone, for all that you've done to bring God into our presence this morning. You ushered him in very well, and I'd just like to thank all the participants for ushering him into our presence today. I also would like to thank my little sister, Sylvia Blake. No, Sylvia, she's not so like a little sister, but I have watched her grow through the Connectional. I watch her work. You are a godsend to the young people and to the young women and the young men as well. So we want to thank you for taking the time out of your busy schedule to come to be with us today and to give us that charge that we need to commit ourselves wholeheartedly to the work of missions. Reverend Blackman, I told you, I knew you was going to bring the thunder. I just didn't know how God was going to package it for us to receive. And I thank you. I thank you from the bottom of my heart for bringing the message to us, allowing us to be in your presence, to hear the word of God as he spoke through you to us this morning. It was a mighty, mighty word that let us know that where we go, it's going to be thunder, because it's going to be change to the community, change to someone that's hurting, change to someone that's in need, and change to someone who's living in a dark space that have been able to be touched by a missionary. So we thank you for the word and the message, and thank you for being one of our very own. You always support us. You're always on the calls. You always support us in our area meetings and in our local meetings. Thank you, Reverend Blackman. Thank you so much to all that join us today, my sisters and brothers across the conference. that thought it not robbery to support little old me this morning and the Martha McCauley area. We appreciate you. We love you. And if there's anything that we can do to support you, please let us know. I just want to say, I want to thank my local president, Faye Hooker, for answering the call to host the Martha McCauley area recommit worship service this morning. Thank you so much, Madam President, for all that you do for us at the local level and beyond. Your leadership is exemplary. You have a beautiful spirit, a very sweet spirit, and a loving and sharing spirit. And we just don't know what we're going to do when your time is up. We're just going to have to change the Constitution and bylaws. Can we do that, Madam President? Okay, we cannot do that. But we love you, and I thank my sisters at the Addie G. Stroud Women Missionary Society for your support of the work of missions. I also would like to, at this time, and thank my pastor, my shepherd, my spiritual leader. Thank you, Reverend Hodges, and my first lady, Sister Dolores Hodges, for your support and your love, being the wind beneath my wings. Mike is on one side, and my pastor, my first lady, is on the other side, and my sisters and brothers have me surrounded in prayer and love. So I just thank you, and I don't want to keep going on because I don't want to put any damper on this high spirit that we are in right now this morning. And I just thank you, God. Thank you, Lord, for all that you have done for us today. We thank you, Father God, because without you, there will be no work of missions. Thank you, Father God, for giving us all the provisions that we need to do the work. Thank you, Father God, for sending the soldiers, sending the ones that want to work in the fields. Thank you, thank you, thank you to all. And if there's anyone that I have neglected to thank, charge it to my head and not to my heart, because I love each and every one of you. Now, Martha McCauley Area Women's Missionary Society, you heard the call. You heard the message. You heard the ministry charge. Let's do the work. Let's bring that thunder to our people and our communities. Thank you. Is Reverend Hodges here this morning? I know that he has some meetings. I don't know if
he was able. Yes, ma'am. That's my mom here.
I would like to introduce to some and present to others my pastor, Reverend Robin Hodges.
This morning when I rose, I didn't have any doubt. This morning when I got up out of my bed, I had no doubt that the Lord would take care of me and the Lord would provide for me, that the Lord would lead me all the way. To our Bishop, Bishop Davis and Mrs. Davis, to all of the leaders of the Missionary Society in the Second Episcopal District, to our own Sister Nikki Lyons, to Sister Diane Twarr, and to our own president of St. Paul, Sister Faye Hooker. Greetings. We praise God that you have allowed us to host this meeting this morning. We are so grateful to you for giving us the opportunity to host such a, spiritual and upstanding Christian women and men of the Missionary Society. I want to thank the Reverend Vias Blackman for that awesome word this morning. Reverend Blackman, thank you. One thing that really stuck out with me, what you said that, do we just hear the thunder or do we bring the thunder? Mm-hmm. I think it's our responsibility in these times and the times that we're in, not just to hear the thunder, but to bring the thunder. The church has to speak up in these times and let the folk know that the God we serve is not just able, he's more than able. So we thank God for you. We thank God for all that you do and all that you continue to do. May God continue to bless you and may God continue to keep you. God bless you.
Amen. Thank you so much, Pastor Hodges. We appreciate your words of encouragement. We just thank everyone again, as our area chairperson said, for attending. I just thank you all for allowing me to preside. This is not an easy thing virtually. I've been on several services, so my hat's off to anyone that even attempts to, because this is not easy because you're so used to that face-to-face, but God is good, and we know there's no distance in prayer or in his spirit. So I would just like to take a personal point of privilege just to also recognize my pastor, Reverend Maren B. Robinson, and my first First Lady, Sister Jennifer Hicks Robinson, and my church family, St. Matthew Raleigh, that's on the call as well. And I just thank each and every one of you all. And we are going to close. Now, this is a sister that brings the thunder, and I love to hear her pray. And so we're going to ask that Sister Linda Badger, our worship leader, come back and close us out in a prayer. And then she's going to recite the missionary benediction on our behalf. But as I said, she doesn't just hear the thunder. This sister brings the thunder. So we'll turn this final portion of our service over to Sister Badger to close this out.
Sister Charlene, before mm-hmm. we end, I would just like to thank the company CTE and our own, the owner, Sydney Cole, for her support and the wonderful way that she helped us to navigate this way of coming to everyone's home. So thank you, Sydney, Ariana, all of you, your company, for helping us to navigate. Isn't God good? He provided us a way that we can still hook up all across the world and still stay connected to Him. Well, we thank you, Sister Sydney, Ariana. Thank you.
Praise God, praise God, praise God Almighty. Woo! Awesome. Just totally awesome. What God has done today and what He would do continually as we seek the thunder of God under our feet, in our hearts, in our minds, and the word of God in our mouths. Our missionary benediction. In the name of the triune God, may the spirit of Christian missions enter every heart. May the spirit of Christian missions enter every heart. This we ask in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Thank you all. I love you. Y'all be safe on the road.
Amen.
Amen. God bless.
God bless you.
I want everybody around the world to put your hands together because all praise belongs to God. Here we go.
Every word of worship,
with one accord,
every prayer.
Having breakfast at Lincolnville. I'm hungry now.
Girl, what you say? And look, I can see it in the back of the church now. The trustees flicking the light saying, that's y'all right. Gotta go.
Oh, so Sister Winifred, tell Lincolnville they owe us a breakfast.